Good afternoon, everybody. Firstly, thanks to Discuss Agile for giving me a slot before lunch. Otherwise, it's really difficult to make people stay awake. So my topic for today is the coffee mug paradigm. I see a few puzzled expressions here and a couple of confused expressions there. To be very honest, I really did not want to bore you guys to death with a lecture. So I decided let's spice things up a bit. And in essence, my topic for today is lean product marketing. But I'll be explaining it through a case study called the coffee mug paradigm. So what is this case study all about? Or before that, let me just introduce myself. So I'm Nitish Gulati. I work as a product owner with Cybrella Technologies. Apart from that, I also run my website and blog on product management. That is www.nitishgulati.com. Feel free to visit it and give your feedback. So what is this case study all about? So I've taken up the food tech sector, which was primarily in the news last year, 2015. I've targeted three companies, TinyOut, DineOut, and Swiggy. The key factor is the coffee mug. So these startups were going nuts over it, and I'll get to it why. The focus was distribution of free coffee mugs to attract customers to stalls. Let's get into a bit of a more situation analysis. So the model was putting up offline marketing stalls at various different locations for each of the three respective startups. The peak time to engage with consumers can be segregated into three slots. The total time for engagement for these three slots would be 420 minutes per day. The location where this case study was done was Wavedog at Hyderabad, and the year was 2015. Now, we've seen a bit of introduction. We've seen some sort of model as to what was happening. Let's see a bit of data as well. So, I've come up with a few metrics. Firstly, staff at the stall. So, there were 3 to 5 for DineOut, 5 to 7 for Swiggy, and 3 to 5 for TinyOut. The stall positions were 2 each for DineOut and Swiggy, and 1 for TinyOut. The number of days over which these stalls were put up were 2 each for DineOut and Swiggy and 1 for TinyOut. The cashback that was getting distributed was rupees 100 for DineOut per consumer. Swiggy did not have any cashback. TinyOut had a coupon wherein they were offering 100% cashback for 150, up to rupees 150. The mugs handed out. So each of them, as I mentioned earlier, the focus was distributing 3 coffee mugs and garnering more attention towards the brands. So the mugs handed out were 420 for DineOut, 168 for Swiggy, and not at all for TinyOut. So I'll get to how we reached this calculation. The stall decoration was rated simple for DineOut, moderate for TinyOut, and grand for Swiggy. Orders achieved, actual revenue, not applicable for DineOut, not applicable for TinyOut, 84 for Swiggy. So the engagement time, as I mentioned earlier, the time slots was 420 minutes per day, so into 2 for 2 days each. For TinyOut, it was 300 minutes per day since they were not available during the first slot. Now what happens in real life? The chief marketing officer or the VP of sales, or for that matter your CEO, could come down to me and tell me, Nitish, you're the product manager, you've given me some basic information. You've given me some data, probably you've given me some metrics also. And to a certain extent, I can measure it. But is it really working? I mean, can I like really put a finger to a point and say that this is why it's successful or this is why it has failed? So in order to, I would like to condense, bring out the things that are underlying to this problem. One, that it's not really lean. Now, as Mr. Sikar from Intel was talking about yesterday, Agile and Lean work hand in hand. Where are the key performance indicators? Now, we do have some sort of data as we saw, but there is no specific KPI through which I can point out that this is what helped in making it a successful marketing campaign. If KPIs exist, which facets of a coordinated marketing campaign are having a positive impact on them? To put it into very simple words, if I do have 3 or 4 KPIs, how do I prioritize and decide that this is going to help me in finding out the success factor or the failure factor for that matter. So in order to clear out this mess, let's introduce something called lean product marketing. Now, obviously there's been a lot of theory being covered around in other sessions. So, but I won't bore you to its theory. So I'll just take a bit of a theory. So what exactly is lean product marketing? Validating learning and being able to judge the needs of early customers. Identifying the minimum viable product and being agile around it with respect to marketing. Value experimentation over planning. Testing and metrics are vital to growth. Now, in order to expand upon these, let's do a practical hands-on. So I'll take you through the business cases of what was happening in those three stalls. For dine out, it was you reach the stall, install the app, you enter code, you straight away get a 100 rupees credit / cashback into your app, and you get a free coffee mug. For Swiggy, it was you go to the stall, install the app, place a minimum order of 50 rupees, and then only will you get a free coffee mug. For Tiny Out, there were two cases. One, you go to the stall, they directly give you a 100% cashback coupon with a maximum use limitation of 150 rupees. The second was they had a dartboard game which you could play up to a level of 5 chances, and you could win a cashback coupon of up to rupees 300 and then get a coffee mug. Now there were a few common observations that I could make out over a period of 2 days in these three stalls. One was network issues. Believe me, Bangalore is my 10th city now and I still face 3G issues. So that's a common problem across all apps. Time to register pre download, less numbers due to costs involved for Swiggy, since they were directly asking for a minimum order to be placed. For Tiny Owl, breakfast time was not included, so they lost out on 120 minutes, precious time, despite paying the rent for that location for that particular day. Now, in order to condense this, what I could observe was that the entire process of reaching to their stall and actually making an order or getting a coffee mug, for Dine Out it was like approximately 2 minutes. For Swiggy it took 4 to 5 minutes for installation and greater time because you had to place an order. And for Tiny Out, it was 3 minutes for playing the game, code redemption and getting a coffee mug. Now we've seen some sort of business cases and factors involved. Let's further drill down and see some metrics. So I've categorized those metrics into two types, tangible and non-tangible. So the tangible factors are the pretty ones, or the same ones which I covered earlier. But I've put an investment number to them. So staff at stall costed 7500 each for dine out and Tiny Out. For Swiggy it costed 10,000. For the rent was 28,000 for 2 days each and 14,000 for Tiny Out since they were present on only on Monday. Cashback. So depending on the marks that I handed out, I could reach an inference of the number of consumers they had and the kind of cashback that I handed out. So for Dine Out, it was the highest, 42,000. Swiggy did not have any cashback policy available at that time. Tiny Out, this is an assumption based on the fact that that initial coupon of 100% cashback was used by each and every guy. The mugs. So I had covered that the mugs handed out were 420 for Dine Out and 168 for Swiggy. So in essence, assuming that each mug, with a bit of research I came to the fact that let's take an approximate number of 50 rupees for each mug. So the cost for mugs was 21,000, 8,400 for Swiggy and 5,000 somewhere around for Tiny Out, assuming that they did give out coffee mugs. Store decoration. I'll cover as to how I reached this number. Orders achieved, none for Dine Out, none for Tiny Out, Swiggy 8,400. Now, I would like to draw your attention to two key figures here, the ones mentioned in red. Now, what is happening with Swiggy?
It's the same mugs.
No.
It's the same
thing,
order mugs.
What they were able to achieve was that they had a minimum order of 50 rupees. So, they were able to recover the cost of the mug. So, essentially, these two figures got nullified out. And that brought down the an overall cost, which you can see from the bolded figures. I'll go to the non-tangible factors. Stall attraction. Well, I wasn't able to get the photos of the stalls. Nonetheless, I tried to paint an accurate picture as to what had happened there. So dynamo was simple. So essentially, they had a simple table like this with some posters behind and 3 to 5 guys standing and selling that dynamo brand. For Tinyurl, it was moderate. Reason being, again, they had a straight enough table with some Tinyurl posters and they had a dartboard game as well. So that kind of added and gave an edge to them. For Swiggy, it was grand. And I mean absolutely grand. Swiggy had like a huge table with a 3D logo and huge red background with a huge LCD TV running Swiggy advertisements. So that was pretty grand. I mean, being a writer, I am a very deep observer of people and things. And what I would have suggested to, what I would have commented on Swiggy's that entire branding thing was, if I am going down a road and I see a MACD, you can easily spot out a KFC as well. But if a Swiggy is standing there, I can easily spot out a Swiggy as well. That was the visual impact of the brand. That's why they got the rating of brand. Customer profitability. So in this I've covered customers like you and me, what are we getting out of it? For Dineout it was grand, since I did not have to put in any effort. I simply got 100 rupees cash back and a free coffee mug, that's it. For Swiggy it was moderate, which is reason being because I had to invest 50 rupees. For Tinyurl it was simple. I could choose to either take the 100% cashback coupon and go on with my life, or I could go ahead with an interaction with them, play a dartboard game, and try to attempt winning a coffee mug. Now we've seen some sort of introduction to the case study. We've seen some data, we've seen some metrics, we've seen what metrics were at play in those 2 days. So let me just condense it and put it to you in terms of Agile. Lead marketing factors used were experimentation, customer feedback, and metrics. I will elaborate on these. So what could the 3 startups have done differently post this analysis? Plan for a sustainable pace. Now when you're in a startup, you have to always run experiments. And you might have a hypothesis to prove that, yeah, this experiment might turn out to be successful. But it could also turn out to be a failure. But in any case, you have to plan for a sustainable pace. When we follow agile models in software development, I cannot ask my developers to build the entire product with a Big Bang approach within 2 weeks. That's not possible. Go ahead and push for that thing. Within the 3rd week, they'll be burnt out and there'll be no productivity. The same thing goes for marketing campaigns. You need to experiment, but you also need to put it in a planned and phased way so that if one of your experiments takes a hit, it doesn't impact your entire investment. Removing impediments. Now, as a product owner, my day-to-day job involves that all the stakeholders involved in the product building with me, if they face any obstacles, I have to ensure that I remove those obstacles. And I would take the example of Tinyurl. Now, in today's generation, nobody has such a long attention span. Despite that, they had an interesting dartboard game, but it was turning out to be pretty lengthy. And that could have been a very attractive factor, but it actually turned out to be a negative factor for them. So they could have probably shortened the game. So that kind of impediment needs to be removed. I mean, you need to judge that through experimentation. Just-in-time reviews, very important. As I mentioned, Dineout was straight away giving 100 rupees cashback plus a free coffee mug without any effort. I don't know where Dineout is today. I honestly don't know. And that's the reason. I mean, on the first day, they could have done this to garner more word of mouth publicity and more attraction towards the brand, towards this store. But then, on the second day, they could have reduced it down. They could have cut it down. They could have reduced the cashback, maybe brought it down to 50 rupees, or they could have removed the cashback entirely. It would have helped them in saving costs. So just-in-time reviews are extremely important, which is a key component of Agile. But the objective of this case study was to reach to a conclusion as to who won using Agile methodology. So we talked about KPIs earlier. So I was able to factor out all these metrics and put it into three paradigms, I would say. The first was consumer is the king. So as I talked about, for Dineout, there was no effort from my side. I simply got a cashback and a coffee mug, of course. So the clear-cut winner in terms of consumer was Dineout. The runner-up was Tinyurl simply because they did lose out on a bit of the lengthy game process. But at least they tried to introduce a physical interaction for the users. So a user could enter to their store and physically interact with the and interact offline with the brand. but that doesn't necessarily convert into online conversions. Wow factor. Overall winner was Tiny Owl, because the moment you reached your stall, they were directly giving you a 100% cashback coupon, plus they were inviting you to play a game, so that kind of attracted people, as per the observations that I had and the word of mouth publicity that I got around. The runner-up was Swiggy, because although they had a very brilliant visual impact in terms of branding, but they had that minimum order thing impacting the number of people coming in and actually placing orders. The most important paradigm which I could consider was balanced market strategy. Now it had three components: ROI, customer acquisition, and customer retention. So in terms of ROI, I pointed out to you earlier that Swiggy was able to nullify the cost of producing those coffee mugs. I think that is that's a brilliant idea to cut down on your ROI. Customer acquisition. The footfalls for Tiny Owl stall and Dine Out stall was very, very high. For Swiggy, the moment people heard you need to place an order, they ran away. But they were able to acquisition customers on the product, actual product. So Tiny Owl, for Tiny Owl, what I could observe was people were interacting with a physical brand, but that doesn't lead to online conversions, as I mentioned. For Swiggy, it actually meant conversions. People were actually using the product and making an order, and that helps. So you get real time feedback as well. Customer retention. Now, I downloaded a Dine Out app, the Tiny Owl app. I used Tiny Owl once because I had the cashback coupon. I did not use Dine Out, and it's uninstalled from my app long time ago. So Dine Out is completely missing from the picture. So in terms of customer retention as well, Swiggy could ensure that even though less customers were using the app, but they were actually using it. And once a customer is acclimatized to that environment, I mean, I did place an order after Swiggy with Tiny Owl, but somehow I was very happy with the Swiggy experience. So the third time I went back with Swiggy. So that is where Swiggy actually was. Yeah.
How would you quantify the retention? Because it will take some time, right? You get the order, you place it, and then you uninstall it.
So for that I had to run around and talk to people. So from the overall paradigms that I could factor out, Swiggy was a clear-cut one winner. In conclusion, what I would like to say was, lean product marketing is a cycle. It's not a big bang approach. You need to experiment, but you also need to do that experimentation in a planned pace. As something akin to an MVP. So MVP is the first word that you hear in Agile. And that's extremely important even in marketing, especially when you're working in the software domain. Measurements like burn-down charts are important. So in the theoretical slide, I had mentioned testing and metrics are vital to growth. And through this data, what we could see was we could quantify something. We could reach to a conclusion, yeah, that this was the factor that enabled Swiggy's success and the failure of the other two startups.
One question is, how...
I'll take your question. Just a quick question. Retrospect helps in maintaining the vision of the brand. So we talked about just-in-time reviews, which Tiny Dine Out could have done. Or we also talked about Tiny Owl's example. They could probably have shortened the length of the game. And they could have done that in the other campaigns in other cities. So retrospects are equally important. Focus on building experience with consumers. Swiggy was able to achieve that big time. So even though they had less number of users, but they could offer an experience to the consumers and they could get a proper feedback as well. So this was just a conclusion from my side. I just took an approach of Agile and applied it to lean product marketing. So this is from my side. You've been a wonderful audience patiently listening to me, and I welcome any questions.
Regarding this burn down chart, so how are you going to apply in the product marketing? When you do an Agile...
See, I just took an example. I did not apply burn down charts here. Mm-hmm. I just took an example saying that, see, you use burn down charts in order to measure your sprint velocity and stuff like that. So you need to do that you need to have a similar sort of approach when you're doing product marketing as well.
So basically when you're trying to go for a campaign or something, you're doing some experiment. So what all things are required, you put in an agile way.
Exactly.
Yeah, I've seen the same way Urban Club even.
Okay.
Urban Club, wherein they provide all the services. Later house joint gaming competitor.
Yes.
Actually, this Urban Club also did the same thing. Coffee mugs, they got into this IT stock. I mean, IT.
If you have products getting copied, so marketing strategies can easily get copied.
send my gift there. Send my gift there. Send my
gift.
I was saying I visited the broker store, and there the thing was you have to purchase grocery worth 500 to get an umbrella and diary.
Yeah, I think I've come across that.
So they could sell for 500 the cost and like half.
Yeah, I think locals did scale up pretty well, but that then they had to scale up pretty well. But then that's part of the experimentation I was talking about. You need to run experiments and see what sort of data you're getting generated out of it.
So for
Dyno,
you still have to install the app, right?
Yeah, definitely.
So in terms of number of cups, does Dyno give out maximum? So they have maximum installation.
Yes, but what's the point of installation if people are not going to use it?
But this one not busy moderator.
I ended up using Swiggy and Tiny Out. So I did not use that Dyno.
I used Zomato and then uninstall it after some reason. I was not able to.
People install cup for coffee mug sake, later they uninstall. They did the same for Urban Club when it's.
Yeah, so you need to give some strong value proposition to the users to actually.
The idea was Zomato has not been able to do that in this case because it's a logical thing. You discover a restaurant place and order there itself.
They ventured into food tech, food ordering.
It's not working, but that's what I'm doing.
They ventured into a couple of things related to food sector, which I can elaborate on offline.
Okay.
But yeah, in any case, one thing is that they were a late entry into the market. Swiggy had the first mover advantage, and I guess they still have that advantage because others are shutting shop. Or did they shut down? Any other question, please?
Can you say lean approach, what you have applied? It is like, what is that wastage that you are trying to, what you are trying to eliminate from this? Basically, lean talks about.
See, I cannot go back to my CMO or my CEO and say that I want 5 lakhs for a marketing campaign.
Okay.
No. He'll throw me out of the office. But if I tell them that I have 10 certain strategies, we could just prioritize on them and start working on a slow basis.
Mm-hmm.
And then we could scale up. So that's the kind of wastage that I'm trying to eliminate. So, I mean, as I mentioned about Dyno, one place is fine that they've distributed so much of cashback in coffee mugs. They could probably improvise upon it and put it into implementation in other cities or in other locations. So that kind of wastage needs to be removed. And that they have to decide based on the data or the feedback that they get.
Just in time also worked out here?
It should have worked out, but then it applied.
Mm-hmm.
So I reached out to Dyno founders, but no response.
No more exists.
And so the takeaways focus on the real users and after.
Key takeaway is data. Data is very important. The other key takeaway is, like she mentioned, eliminating wastage. As I gave her an example, I cannot go out with a big bang approach. It's not feasible in today's world. But over a period of time, you can figure out what is working for you. And if you have some data to prove it, then all the more like it.
So basically, the KPIs or the metrics, what you try to measure, is going to give a strategy to show how well you performed.
Exactly. So it's not only about discovering why you failed.
Yes.
A couple of months down the line, even if some investor comes and asks you that, why were you successful in the first place? You need to pinpoint the reason. If you don't have such KPIs, you won't be able to even tell why you succeeded in the first place. This is important. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I hope I